Sweet. I get a map where you definitely want to start on that city side. However, like I said, still a bit of a touch and go when it comes to city plays. So, in that sense, sometimes it can actually favor you if you get that T start. Some teams seem to be a bit more comfortable. I think at least they've established or managed to make this map less of a city-sided map. I feel like that's a fair thing to say, but it's going to be a 1-on-5 for Device.
Easy.
So, a lot of things.
He jumped on his head.
Playing some Super Mario here. Jumping around, just, you know, may as well. May as well, it's just the best of 5. May as well just spend some time in the background.
As you do. One thing I want to mention, I mean, if you weren't looking at a team like Fnatic going into this map, I would have actually said that if this was me, if I was up 2-0 in the third map, perhaps the deciding map, I would maybe rather start on the T side simply because you can play with less pressure. And if you can just start getting a few rounds on T, if you get the pistol, say you get the pistol, and then you get the first buy round, you've got already a pretty decent half and the other team is just going to be on absolute tilt. Whereas if you here start off the CT side and the other team gets a few rounds early on, then that can be the other way around.
Dennis is pushing in, but it's going to be traded kills and two more CTs pushing in Ivy. And it's Fnatic just coming out with the kills and leaving Sipnix alone here. And there was an execute coming from Astralis that never happened just because Fnatic playing as aggressively as they did. And the bomb has gone down as well. And that's going to be Flasha there just holding the bomb. And a bit of a stack Aroni from the CT's own yard. But Flasha does spot Sipnix, so he has the knowledge of where he is. So everyone from the CT side is pushing in from Ali and Krims. Connecting on that last kill as well, so that was over before it really even started, to be fair. As I said, Astralis was looking to have a bit of an execute, and that's going to be frustrating. I mean, like I said, Astralis, especially that second map, it felt like they should have had it. It was one of the maps that we felt they had a comfortable opportunity on picking up and putting themselves on this into the series, but now that Fnatic makes it happen, it is definitely not looking great for Astralis. Especially after a pistol round like that.
And with Dennis then opening up once again. Dupree looking for it, but isn't going to find anything. And then Dennis takes down the second. All of us here, he even has the body system in play with JW. And there's just really no way in.
The scary thing about Fnatic is when they get into this yellow mode where they're just running around and they're just toying with you. It just keeps getting more and more frustrating from your opponent's standpoint, and Fnatic is super good at that. But Device is gonna get that shot on Dennis. Dennis is gonna pay the price of peeking. But it's still a 4-3 in favor of Fnatic. Make it a 4-2 as Flusha gets a kill. But an interesting situation here with Krims and Device, and Krims gets the kill. So again, Sipnix alone in a very, very tough situation. He needs to show some incredible legal skills to make this work.
I mean, at least he almost has a bomb site here, but he just doesn't have the bomb anyway. Yeah. I mean, I talked about on Overpass, you know, how I felt that the T side, or pretty much the whole game from Fnatic's point of view, wasn't won so much on, you know, tactical masterpieces, but more the fact that individuals stepped up. And this pistol round that we just saw, that was a tactical masterpiece. 3 guys pushing Ivy was beautiful, and this could be beautiful. Dennis with one can't quite find more than just one, but that would have been the play of a century. And instead, it is Astralis who do actually pick up 2 kills, but not anymore. But imagine Dennis coming in with the MP7 there and sprays down all 5.
Yeah, that could have been called the meat grinder. But only picking up 2 kills, still a pretty good investment for him. A lot of money. And look at this, Olaf is going to stick with that Mag 7. JW on an op. It's going to be full buy on both sides. Device with an AWP for the Astralis team as well. He doesn't have any nades, but can still work for them. Look at this, already 2 T's are in T quad. So a fast yard push is coming in.
Yeah, they do have a bit of map control, but Fnatic playing this very well. Letting Astralis use all of their smokes and then just sitting in passive positions waiting for them to actually push onto the bomb site. And it isn't going to happen just yet, but Cajun going to be taken down flush, and that's a big K kill to open up this bomb site. Now it makes it so much harder for Fnatic to actually hang on to this bomb site, where they now only really have two players and then one guy on Ali. But when you have all of Mice, you really don't need much more. The Vice does take him down though, and that actually, you know, once again puts it in favor of Astralis. And then the pre with a kill onto Crims means that this should more or less be a round that has been decided by the frags, and you know, they are still going to be playing it, so there is obviously always still a chance.
Yeah, but it's a very off chance at this point. JW makes it a 1-on-3, but there's a lot of angles he's going to be having to face, so the best thing right now for him is to try to get some extra kills and try to save this op for the upcoming round. He's going to miss that shot on Dupree. He's going to face again and gets a kill on Sipnix. So, still very likely that he's going to manage to save this. All things considered, not a lot of money for Astralis either, obviously. So, they're better off trying to save these weapons as they are. But let's see what Fnatic's economy looks at this point. Yeah, they can still justify to play on this one, considering JW does keep that up. They could even double up if they wanted to. See what they decide to do. It's gonna be, yep, double op it is. JW and all of them. But yeah, a pretty passive hold from the CTs. Astralis early control of the yard, but then just holding and waiting for Fnatic to make the next move. And Astralis then trading kills properly, having that bomb side control, eventually getting the bomb down. But there you have it. JW has pushed Ali. He's got that kill on Cajun. A lot of information as well, as the rest of the T's are already pushing inner bomb side, which has two CTs there. Olaf and his teammate, and it looks like Astralis is not going to actually commit to the side. It looked like they're just going to push in when they, on the very last second, decide to not make it happen and just wait for a new opportunity.
Fnatic used two smokes on blocking out the same area there. And that means that now JW just used the last smoke on the CT side, so with only 1 minute being taken off this clock, they've already used all of their smokes, and this definitely favors Astralis. So if they can find the picks now and use their utility, they will be victorious.
That's a big kill.
Two big kills.
Yeah, Sipnik's getting that kill through the smoke. It's gonna be Crims Healer still on the site, but he gets killed by Kerrigan. So it's a 2-on-4 situation. JW and Dennis left here for Fnatic. And no defuse kits either, so they're just gonna be falling back really at this point. Not a lot to play for them. But yeah, Sipnix getting that kill through the smoke on Olaf, who was pushing high or up a ramp, trying to get a pick on the bomb side. And then another kill from Astralis as well. That was pretty much the bomb side down and wiped from CTs.
I don't know if I'm really late, but I just now realized why JW has Voldemort as his picture. It's because his orb is called the Elder One. But anyway, a good round by Astralis, a very well worked round. They're using the nades very, very effectively, and they also managed to actually force out a lot of grenades early on from Fnatic, and that's kind of, you know, unusual from Fnatic. It's not really a team where you can force out their nades very easily, but this time they used them prematurely.
There's a tendency from Astralis here where they'll make it seem like a push using a smoke and a flash, and then just stalling for another 15 or 20 seconds. And then making the push right after that. They did the similar thing on both the first and the second map as well, and they really made it work beautifully. And that's going to be a Fnatic here on an awkward call to buy. It's going to be a 3-on-3 situation.
And Device and JW in just a game of patience here. The smoke is blocking off vision from both players now. But Device is going to be winning the battle, and I think that's actually what wins the round. Whoever got that kill wins the round, in my opinion, and Device shows that is the case. He didn't actually... I think he's 4x3. I don't think he realized that Dennis is here, but he could see him on the screen. At least we could here on the stream. So had he been playing 69, I think he potentially could have seen him. But instead, Dennis is now allowed to make a push, and he knows where Cajun B is as well, but Cajun does take him out. That could have actually been very, very scary, simply because Device either using the proper resolution or not really paying attention to the corners of his screen, which is, you know, fair enough.
Yeah, and Tricky plays there from last CT, throwing the smoke, almost making it work, getting the kill on the ball planner, but not making, managing to get the second kill. And that's a round for Astralis. That's going to be a save for Fnatic at this point as well. So, even though Fnatic having a great start, Astralis has returned the favor, made it a 3-3, and it's going to be an outer push, but Dennis is the one opening the kill. Making the first kill, but Sectix is going to trade it off, and Device also on Olaf. Carrigan on JW as well, so the situation is going in favor of Astralis very quickly. Now it's only going to be Crims alone here. And needs a miracle at this point. Almost gets a kill on Zipnix. It's going to be down to 2 HP, but there you have it. Astralis on the lead for the first time on Train.
Yeah, and Train is one of those maps. You said it yourself that, you know, it historically has been very CT-sided. It is a bit more even now, but still a map where you can definitely, I mean, a 9-6 on CT isn't too rare. So Astralis, with already four rounds, is very, very good. And it's kind of the case that if they do win this round, then Fnatic, they've used all of their economy. They do get 3,400 for losing five rounds in a row. But then you still have to make the decision, do we want to buy up again? Do we want to eco this? We want to play Ops, of course, it's Train. And that's what I really like about Train, actually. The T side always has good economy, more or less, because the bomb plants are so easy to get, and the CTs are struggling as soon as they struggle to get rounds. But JW opening things up onto Device, and it's the AWP battle, the straight AWP battle going down. But then Cajun gets a frag, and Astralis are just doing wonders here, finding frags everywhere on the map, even at you know, a numerical disadvantage. But Olaf,
yeah, he's gaining a lot of information. He's gonna know this rotation right now. He's gonna be on a direct flank, but instead, look at this. Oh, the timing. Is it gonna be a friend for Olaf? It is not right now. What could have been had he got that kill? And now Fnatic is favored in this situation with that flank coming in, but Flash is getting those two kills. It's going to be Dupree alone here on the bomb side, taking a duel with Olaf. Both connecting slightly. Dupree actually gets that kill on Olaf, but then Flush comes in and sweeps the third kill. Yeah, interesting. Just Olaf's intuition again, once again. I mean, he realized the situation. It was only going to be that smoke and a flash. It was just a fake in the end from Astralis. Olaf pushed up in the lower ramp. You know, in a best case scenario, he might have even gotten the bomb down onto the top of the ladder. But Sipnix managed to get down the ladder. Still, Fnatic wins that one. That's going to be 4-4. Full buy on both sides still.
Yeah, and it's actually the T's with the most utility here. Dennis also only with a FAMAS, so as far as weapons go, they do have two AWPs on the CT side, but JW now also has a kill to his name, and that makes it much easier for them getting into this round. JW with yet another, and a third, the hat-trick of frags for JW. The AWP extraordinaire for Fnatic, and then Cajun, last man remaining, but surely will be picked off. JW once more misses the flick, actually. It could have cost him a weapon. But,
I mean, that's what happens when you leave or give JW room to roam. Don't manage to pressure him from multiple angles at the same time. Instead, he was given the opportunity to get those picks, you know, without too much resistance from the T's. And there you have it. Fnatic is going to have that fifth round on the board. It's going to be 5-4. And it's going to be Astralis on a save as well. Just a smoke and a flash. See how they decide to use this. What a lot of teams do, actually, is they go to inner bomb site on these ecos, because a lot of CTs played quite passively on the inner bomb site. And that enables the possibility for a bomb plant in there.
I think it's also, even if the CTs do not play passive, if they do play it aggressive, there's a bigger chance that you actually get a close quarters duel, and that kind of just makes your pistols more effective. But the goose coming in here, Dennis calmly taking two players out, removing them from the server. There's no armor on the T, so there's really not much they can do here.
A bit of an overly complicated round from Astralis. They tried to like fake that typical smoke down lower flash, and you know, going down in the lower or inner bomb site to plant the bomb. Instead, they faked it and went outside. That's interesting, and maybe slightly too complicated.
We talked about in-game leaders stepping up on Train, and Flush is here with 13 kills and 10. And Olaf has one kill to his name.
I mean, when you have a lineup with as much star power as Fnatic, then You have one player just sitting at one and still do pretty well. It's okay sometimes. It happens. When you're Fnatic.
But he's not really been too good friends with the timing either, as you like to call it. Now JW gets taken down, and it seems that when they do remove JW from the round, they usually do win them. So curious to see what happens next for Astralis here. The CTs have a 2-2 split, and so if they hit the outer bombsite, that should favor Astralis. Now Dupree will be calling that no one has actually pushed B yet, and therefore he might be thinking that they're stacking towards the A bombsite. But it does not look like that's the case. And they're just playing very passive, trying to see if any CTs get overconfident. But yeah, currently it's just a very, very slow round, actually.
Yep. It seems like a bit of a trademark for Charlie. They'll maybe even do a late fake here and then still push another bomb site. But bomb is just roaming around a bomb ladder, so it is feels like it's going to be inner push. But Crims gets that double kill. Timing was his friend. He makes it work, but in the meanwhile, the rest of the T's are actually pushing outer bomb site. As we know, bomb site in itself is actually clean, but Flash are getting killed Cajun, but Kerrigan trading it off, and it's going to be Dennis here. It's going to leave Sipnix alone. It was in connector. It has the bomb too. So he could potentially get that bomb plant. It's 5 seconds left. He needs to commit on this bomb plant. But Crims with the third kill of the round. It's going to seal the deal. Just great timing from Crims' part. He pretty much nullifies that situation. It seems like the plan altogether for Astralis was to try to fake that inner bomb site and go down ladder and take the bomb to the outer bomb site. But Crims being the big player of the round for Fnatic.
I don't really understand the decision-making from Astralis there. Why would you have two players trying to cover each other like that? It's much better for Dupree to be at a wider angle so that if Crims peaks, then he at least only gets one on the spray. In this scenario, he actually lines up both players, or they line each other up, and he can easily kill them both off with one spray.
But here comes the other push from Astralis. They've already got an into the quad. Hit the quad and device. Gets that first kill. The bomb is down too, but then Flash and Dennis get the kills afterwards, making it a 4-3 in favor of Fnatic. It's an effort plan situation. One of the T's is actually in connector. Dupree here. He could be a player to watch in this situation, really. If he times everything correctly. Look at the sweet time that Fnatic has taken. Time is actually running out, so they need to make a play here. They need to get this defuse going on. The defuser is actually really low on HP. He goes down, but he does not all have managed to get the kill on both on Cajun and Sipnix. Flash was down to 16 HP, just one more bullet on him. He would have been down and the bomb would have exploded. It's a very, very close round. With pretty minimal investment from Astralis. Getting some Tech-9s, a few smokes, getting that bomb down. At least the best thing for them at this point, at least, is the fact that they get that bomb down. So that means that some extra cash and making sure they have everything they need going into this round number 13.
Oh, and already Cajun has been legged. And JW keeps peeking and peeking and peeking. Cajun not going to fall to the nade, actually. I thought he would. Crim's going to be taken down to pre, and then Sipnix returns. So it is a 4v4 situation. But JW behind this smoke. Every time I watch these rounds play out with X-Ray, you're sitting there like, spray the smoke, but it just never happens. So JW does still stand
tall.
Was that
a leg shot?
I think he hit him through the train, actually. That's what happened. And then he only took slight damage.
Yep, got a 3-3 situation here, though. Flash on the old lone man here on this outer bomb side, while on his team is in Ivy Alley. And, we actually have Olaf pushed on top of ladder, I think it is. So that's probably going to be a lot of information at this point for Fnatic, knowing that it's definitely going to be outside bombsite. It's going to be pushed, and that's where the T's are too. Just waiting for the right moment to get that bomb down.
I like how they fake the bomb plan, actually. It's very interesting. They were definitely hoping that Olaf would be running down the ladder, and Sipnix now. Oof, the timing is his friend this time, it seems. But not quite, actually. he delays it a bit too much. And I don't really understand the game plan from Fnatic there. It seems like they peaked kind of one by one by one. It doesn't really make it very hard for Sipnix. We actually saw him quite a few times go out of the ladder room to peek towards the bomb site. And if Olof had timed that better with his teammates, perhaps they could have killed off Sipnix and changed the outcome of the round.
Yeah, again, massive patience from Astralis there. They virtually had the bomb site there for a good 35-40 seconds, but they just delayed the bomb for a long time. And then Device getting those two crucial kills, obviously, in that 3-on-3. Sealed the deal pretty much, Olof alone in the 1-on-3, not managing to time correctly, going down the ladder. And that's it, round for Astralis. But it's still going to be a full bot for Fnatic at this point. Another slow round for the Danes, though. I'm just waiting for Fnatic to make some plays on the CT side. So really not, apart from the fact that there's two of them, is actually playing quite aggressively on the art this time around that E-box area.
Device almost finding the angle through the smoke, but not quite. He does get a lot of map control here, or at least he gets quite far pushed. JW takes down Carrigan, and now Dennis spraying all of his shots through the smoke and doesn't quite connect. But then Flusher takes down Sipnix. Cajun B could be the man of the hour if he just times this right. Device with a double kill. And then Dupree with another. And now it's JW. JW takes one. And I am not counting this guy out of the round just yet. As we know, he is definitely one of the players that you will be looking to clutch for Fnatic. And having just two more players to find with 30 seconds left. He does have his AWP. He also has two kills already.
The bomb is down in team main. It's being picked up. So, but they have no idea where JW is right now. As he's rotating all the way to Ivy. But now he's nowhere as he misses that shot. Now the bomb side is in a very good position. It's going to attack Dupree. It's going to attack JW down to 40 HP. There's no need for either of the two T's to peek at this point. The time keeps or needs to wind down for them. It's playing in their favor. JW at this point, it's going to be a very hard situation, and there you have it. Dupree gets that kill on JW as well. But yeah, I mean, that things just changed in a matter of seconds when Device got that double kill.
Yeah, and I think maybe JW was just slightly out of range, so he couldn't hear the plant come down. I'm not quite sure, but he didn't peek it, and had he done that, that would have changed into a one versus one. Of course, I do see where the players are, so it is a bit easier, but still. Then missing the shot on KGB rotating away also meant that he made the clutch much harder for himself, as he had given away his whereabouts. But JW, this time, wanted to actually try to get back into it, but Dupree takes him down already. And then Olof with one onto Dupree. And Astralis, this is not going to be easy. All four players have rotated over to the B-bomb side, more or less, and Device, last man standing, gonna be hard for him, and he gets taken down.
Problem is, when you're going to the inner bomb site, if you're getting delayed too much into pushing aggressively all the way down through that bomb site, it gets very hard for the T's to get that bomb down and defend it. They didn't even manage to actually get that bomb down in any situation. JW, with that just one kill, managed to delay the push long enough for things to work out great for Fnatic, and they're sitting at 9-6. Half, and that's, you know, that's pretty much the sweet spot on or the bare minimum, I guess you could say, from both angles, really. But it's gonna be the second pistol round. Fnatic has opted to buy just armors across the board, no nades, so it's gonna be like a heavy execute for them. Similarly for Astralis, they only have armors as well. And it seems like four of the Fnatic members are pushing in, and Device is gonna be the man of the hour here. It's gonna be facing a lot of T's at this point, but it's Dennis. Actually, it's going to be two Fnatic players in alley. They can get that first kill. It's going to be Dupree down zone. So no need for Fnatic to make any decisions really here. They're just going to be waiting for the perfect opportunity with a minute and 10 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah. So what they're doing now is just, you know, Astralis kind of know that they are down a man. And so they know that they must somehow even up the odds. And the only way to do so is by pushing aggressively or finding a Fnatic player out of position. But yeah. Fnatic kind of playing the mind games here by just making sure to play together and then playing passively for long enough for them to get into the right positions. Now Carrigan already digged, and then Cajun gets taken out by Dennis. So Kerrigan needs to come up big, and so far he has. And Dennis with one, Flusher with one, and Device also eventually going to be taken out. So pistol round for Fnatic, and this is more or less 12-6 already, which is very, very hard to get back from for Astralis.
Yeah, kind of interesting that Astralis loses that first man and they still decided to play two on both sides. Instead, I felt like they need to take a risk at that point. You want to probably bank on that Otter bomb side and just have three playing there. Just heavily stack one of the choke points of the map, but instead they decided to play with two on both bomb sides. Doesn't work in their favor. Fnatic is just raining here throughout. Some Mac action from Olaf. And just a waiting game. But look at this though. Dupree has pushed up in alley, so he's got some information going on here. He's playing a interesting angle, just waiting there for a potential T to push in. But that's no one's there actually. So Fnatic is seemingly going to this inner bomb side momentarily.
Yeah, and just pistols. They decided to actually not force up into this second round, which is a bit unusual. The current meta has been for a long time, actually, to always force up in the second round after losing the pistol. But JW and then JW, he's just going to be taking down two players. And, you know, without armor, it's once again really, really hard for Astralis to get anything from this. And when Kerrigan also gets taken down, the round is already over. All they can do now is hope for exit franks.
Yeah. They're just trying to make some... trying to get the exit kills in there. Therefore, force Fnatic into buying or rebuying some weapons here. JW does get dinked down to 1 HP by Device. Is he going to get more than that? Is the question, really. Dennis is going to meet up with Dupree here. Is Dupree going to get it? Nope, he's not. He's going to run out of ammo on those CZ. Device though, he has a UMP now. Let's see if he can utilize that in the following round. It's an interesting SMG, to say the least.
Do you think they'll buy up on this though? He might buy a body armor, but that's all I think he'll buy.
I mean, I don't even think it really is an idea for him to. I mean, for him specifically, because he's the opper, he wants to have an op going into this first weapon round. He may have dropped it to someone else. He could have just bought an armor, but for Device to do it, I don't think it really makes sense. And as we can see, none of them is buying an armor. That's going to be Dennis and JW already outside bomb site. Two first kills going in the favor. The first kill going in the favor of Astralis. I mean, Fnatic. And then it's going to be a 4-2. Make it a 4-1 in just a matter of a few seconds. It's going to be a lone Device with that UMP.
There's really no reason to save this. I mean, they're going to be buying up into next round anyway, so this UMP is more or less useless. All he can use it for is to try and get a kill on Fnatic, and then if he's lucky, he can maybe get away with an AK, but I think it's very unlikely. But there's absolutely no reason for him to not play this, in my opinion, as he doesn't have any armor.
Yeah, he gets spotted by Dennis. So the surprise factor for Device is gone, and he's going to get raided by the T's, and Olaf is going to get that kill with that Mac. Mac Daddy. Coming into play.
Now Device picks up the AWP. I mean, if he had bought a body armor instead of the smoke there, what he could have done is get an AWP and a body armor instead of now an AWP and a head armor, which doesn't really actually help him much. Olaf still does have a MAC-10, but it's very unlikely that he'll be at a range where Olaf will be winning a fight versus an AWP.
Look at this, Dennis already in T-Quad. He's doing that play that we were discussing. I like to do. Olaf is going to get that first kill with the on Device, and Dennis is going to connect on Kerrigan as well. So that's a quick 5-on-3 in favor of Fnatic. Let's see if it's just going to be Fnatic swarming in this outer bomb site.
It looks to be the case. Dupree does get a consolation frag, at least consolation for now. With just one more frag, it does get somewhat possible. Cajun is definitely looking for it, but he's not going to be getting it just yet. And then Caden gets taken out. Dupree should be following soon. He's very low on HP. And he does not actually get taken down by JW. And Dupree actually also makes it out. So,
yeah, it's still a minute to play here for Fnatic. But Dupree really, he goes on this monster flank. He's going to go try and go into T main. Meanwhile, Sipnix needs to try to get that next kill. Try to delay the bomb plan as long as possible. It's going to be his primary goal at this point. This could very well actually work out for Astralis. But it does not. Wallace is going to get the pick, but Siblings is going to get a kill on JW. So it's a 1-on-2. Siblings versus Olaf and Krims. Siblings gets the first kill on Krims, so makes it a 1-on-1, but only 2 HP left. No kit. So it's going to be a tough one, and there we have it. Olaf is going to go right away. And Siblings is going to try and go for that defuse. It's going to be a 13-6 scoreline for Fnatic, and yeah, it's looking even more grim than ever for Astralis at this point.
It's one of those rounds for Olaf where you're not going to ever see it in a highlight video, but it's actually a massive round from him. The fact that he reads the play that Dupree makes and gets that kill totally changes how the round pans out. Yep. Dupree could potentially have killed off the bomb planner and maybe gotten another kill just by surprise, and then they've more or less won the round. So him also outplaying Siblings there is phenomenal, and really, really huge round from Olaf.
Yeah. Look at this, JW is going to go throw in team mid. He's going to get the first kill, but Kerrigan is going to be there to trade it. And Krims and Dennis getting the next two. Only going to leave Device and Siblings here in Z connector. They're going to get Molotov'd and smoked off. And they're going to have to rotate to the back halls of the other. The back wall, or rather, I guess. Bomb is down. No defuse kit for either of the two CTs either. I think Dennis spotted one of the CTs. Oh yeah, this is pretty much virtually impossible situation for Astralis at this point.
Siblings does get one. He does actually drop the AWP, and Fnatic are quite far away, so maybe he can make sure they can't save this AWP, but that's kind of the best he can do, and I think they still will pick up the AWP. Maybe not. They aren't actually gonna. But
yeah, again, just a great example of Fnatic's playstyle. So just JW, basically, them knowing that money is grim for Astralis, it's not going to be a lot of pre-nades probably from Astralis. So they just walked out. JW gets the first kill. He gets traded away, but instantly two of Fnatic players get this, get another two kills, and that's pretty much the round over within just a matter of seconds.
What do you think about the decision of Astralis here forcing up? Would you rather have waited and played for the overtime?
Feel like they're at tilt mode at this point, to be honest with you, considering what happened in the previous map and how these rounds have been working out. But there you have it, though. Dupree is going to get a kill on the flash with that scout.
Look at the lurk here from Cajun. One, almost a second. Oh. There we go. Doesn't have to challenge the third, and he does not. So very cleverly played by him. And now he can also cut off the rotation from his teammate, SJW, with 50 HP. Looks like KDB kind of wants to go down there, but that's actually Device picking up JW. But huge round by Cage, and
yeah, timing also friend for him, definitely there.
Yeah,
getting those two kills.
And there he gets the third.
Yeah, and that's a lot of money in the bank. There we go.
I mean, I would actually say, it's obviously much easier for me to say now, but I like the decision of forcing. When you're on 14-6, you could potentially eco and just play for the overtime, but against a team like Fnatic, there will be one, you know, odd round, even if you go on the most insane comeback ever. You're not going to be picking up 9 rounds in a row versus a team like Fnatic. I mean,
yeah, a 14-7, it still doesn't look very likely. They'll need to make some magic happen. With Kerrigan opens up on a kill on Krims, but JW there to trade it off. Does get hurt down to 13 HP though, but he's going to be there in T quad already. Oh, that's early pressure toward the other bomb side. Flasha gets a kill on Dupree. And then it's going to be kills back and forth. They get it 3-on-2 in favor of Astralis. But look at that Device. Oh, it did no scope shot.
Oh, perfect timing for Dennis and JW. JW actually not even properly noticing that Device was there. But one versus one, the mind game's definitely coming into play. And they're just avoiding each other for now.
Yeah, merry-go-round. See who's going to be the lucky one when it comes to timing. The bomb is down at that bomb site. Dennis is just going to be waiting. Cajun is just trying to roam around, really. And now seems like he's going to be happy with just peeing around here. Never mind. He actually is going to go in the bomb site. So they're just going to be dancing here around this map.
Dennis has a good position. Cajun is going to be working past at some point. It's kind of inevitable, but with the time running so low, that's why he now has to make a decision this round is very important for Fnatic, because if they win this, they've more or less won the game. They're going to be resetting Astralis, and there's really no way to get back into this. But Cajun, by winning this round, he could enable his team to at least have a shot at getting back
Dennis,
into this.
Need to run. Need to run, brother. There we go. Bomb goes down in the inner, so now the advantage definitely is in Dennis's side. It's a good plant. There's a lot of angles he could be at.
The only saving grace for Cajun could be the fact that he has a Molotov and does have a kit.
Yep.
But yeah, it's a very, very hard clutch for Cajun. He doesn't have much time to work with. He has to spot out Dennis. He's jumping all around the trains here, but Dennis is just playing this so smart. Cajun goes off the bomb and Dennis sees this. There's really no reason to face, and he could even flash out now to just be 100% sure that it's Ooh. Not the case. But Cajun,
what a flick.
Yeah, and that's actually why, you know, he should have flashed out. When he hears the fate, even if he throws the flash into the wall, it most likely directs Cajun's attention to it. Then he can go and shoulder peek again. And
yeah, Dennis wanted to really commit on that first one, but only seeing a glimpse of Cajun's head there. And it's going to be Cajun in a second map in a row in a very dire situation for Astralis, giving and saving Astralis for another round, at least. So it's going to be 14-8. It's going to be a bit of a, well, you could say forced buy, but it's really not. Just one tech 9 and 8 OP, and Dennis is going to open up on Dupree. It's going to get a kill on Cajun B as well. It's just going to be, again, just kills being traded, and it favors Fnatic once again. It's going to be 3-on-2. The bomb is going to be on Flusha, who's actually falling back to team mid. Still a minute and 20 seconds here to work with, so they don't really need to make a commitment to either bomb site. They can just wait, and all of this on the hunt. He's on the flank here. I think he's going to be facing Device here, and Device with the no-scope headshot, changing the situation into a 2-on-2.
And once again, it's the same case as before. This time even more important for Astralis, because the comeback could actually be on. They are on the favored side, and if they win this round without even giving Fnatic a bomb plant, they would be sending them to eco, but they do get the bomb plant, and that favors Fnatic. But now the flusher drops low, I'm not so sure. And Device, oof, very, very close. Great flash, JW. Yep. Fantastic work. One versus one, it's looking more and more like a JW round, but Device does have a smoke. He smokes off the bomb. He does have a kit as well. He can fake it. JW is going to be taken out through the smoke in these individual plays from Astralis right now. Just getting him back into this, it seems.
Yep, Device hitting that no-scope headshot into Olaf and then clutching that 1-on-1 in the end. Putting Astralis in 9 rounds, and Fnatic is going to be decision-making time for them, because their bank is definitely not healthy. But they know at the same time, but there's not a lot of money on Astralis' side either. I think it's a reasonable decision from them. It's going to be Tech9's and Eagle, and one CZ. Molotov smoking 2 flashes, and armor is across the board for them. And they're trying to utilize those operator pistols. They are one of the teams who are famously super good at these kind of rounds, so you definitely don't count them out in this kind of round.
No, never. Now, Astralis, I think it's going to crumble for them if they do not get the first frag, simply because I would imagine that things could start to go dire. But it is Cajun picking up the first one, and that's Dennis. That's also the Deagle, so the biggest pistol removed. Now it's all left to the three Tech9s and the single CZ, and it's a very, very hard round for Fnatic to win.
Yep. Seems like it's going to be a harder push for them. There's only one member just pushing into T quad. Creams does get that first kill on Karrigan. Now JW pushing Ivy. He's not going to connect on Dupree. He's going to have to reload his weapon and go for another push. But all of a sudden, Astralis gets those next two kills, and that makes it a 4-2 in their favor. They get a 4-1. Now, Flasha only, and he gets a pick on Sipping Stone. You never know with a Tech 9. Oh, another kill as well, but then Device comes in. It's going to seal that deal. They get into a 14-10. But those kills, though, they're going to hurt Astralis. That means there's going to be less, a little bit less utility for them. It's going to mean they're going to be 100% fully committed on into this round. Everyone except for Cajun, really low on money. At the same time, Fnatic have all the utility. No AWP in the play, though.
Only for Device. And Olof is just going to be going totally aggressive here. He might actually go through this, and he does. And then the Molotov comes out, and that's actually very lucky timing from the CTs.
Yeah, but that's a good thing for Fnatic. They've managed to force out a lot of nades for Mestralis to start off the round, but it's going to be potentially an inner push right away for the Swedes. They are waiting for the right moment. There's two CTs on that bomb site. So, see how they fare. Sipnix with that Mac. And they have Cajun with that FAMAS. So, not the best weaponry for the CTs on this site.
That's actually pretty much the worst weaponry from the players. But Sipnix with one, with two, and Device. And then Sipnix gets taken down. But it's all left to Olof all of a sudden as Device takes yet another. And yeah, I mean, they know where he is, so he's going to be going down any second.
It's not always a matter of how good your weaponry is, it's how you use it. And Sipnix getting those two kills with the Mac 7, playing a huge part. And Cajun getting one more with the FAMAS and Device chiming in as well, leaving Olof in a 1-on-4 situation. And that was not going to be happening. It's going to be Fnatic on another save, so Astralis pulling a bit of a comeback here on the second half. What was it, at worst, 14-7, was it? So
yeah, 14-6 even, like, I think.
Yeah, it's been 4 or 5 rounds in a row for Astralis at this point. And another armor pistol round for Fnatic. But like we said previously, you never want to count them out on these ones. You never know what happens. They still have a smoke and a grenade as well. So you got to be careful when Astralis. Don't want to give any free kills to the Swedes.
Well, that's definitely something you want to avoid. Olof going full Rambo here, and he actually does get down out to the B bomb site. So he's pulling a bunch of rotations. He's pulled another player over, and now yet another. So there's only two players on the outside bomb site, and they do realize that Fnatic, unfortunately, don't really try to play off of this. JW going for the Deagle headshots. He had a lot of luck earlier, but this time not so much. He's going to go with the body shot instead. And then Crims takes down one. So they find another one. This might be doable. Cajun does take a bit of spam. And JW with only one HP needs to stay alive, or his team is pretty much out of this round.
Yeah, problem is the bomb is down in team main. It's only Cajun and Sipnix left though. Against Crims, he does massive damage to Sipnix, but he gets away with it. He picks up the kill. He picks up the AWP back to Device as well. But like we said, that was just a pistol and armor kind of a buy from the Swedes.
Yeah, and as you can see here on the bets, Astralis have 11 odds and Fnatic have 1.01. So if Fnatic do end up actually throwing this match, and Astralis do get back, this will
be
11.
Did you just say throwing?
Yeah,
we gotta be careful with those words.
Didn't read too much into it, but I mean that will be giving you 11 times your bet back. Gotta love live odds, and yeah. Gotta love Astralis and this comeback. Hopefully they can make it work.
If you believe, I mean, there's always the YOLO factor in play. Crims is gonna spot, I think it was Device, you know, who goes down to 29 HP. He was on top of 5 train. They had a cheeky little boost in that ladder house. Ladder room, Pop Dog. They do a lot of damage, but no kills made for either one. And just a bit of a waiting game. Just a minute on the clock at this point in time.
So Astralis playing very passive, and Fnatic looking for an opening. Dennis is going to be throwing a smoke. I'm not quite sure where that lands actually, but I would assume it lands over towards the connector area. Olof going to be rushing in, entry fragging once again here on the T side of train, but gets taken out by Sipnix, who really has been winning pretty much every single battle versus Olof. But JW and Flusher, they're changing the outcome of this round. And then a good grenade going to be bouncing in. Actually only does about 5 damage to Sipnix. And
Device and Sipnix both down too. Quite low HP, so this could be a hard retake. Dennis gets the kill on Sipnix as well, so it's going to be a 2-4. Dupree getting the kill. A bit of a chance for Astralis, but it gets whittled down by Flash's kill on Dupree. So Device opts to go back full all the way. Make sure he has that op to work with into round number 28. So finally, Fnatic on the board after losing multiple rounds in a row. Even though they lost the first guy, they got the kill number 2 and 3 of the round. And Sipnix being down to low HP together with Device, making it a super hard retake for the Danish team.
Natsu, are you a football fan?
I'm more into ice hockey because I'm Finnish.
Well, I think the analogy kind of still works because there's offside in ice hockey as well.
Yeah, there is.
Yeah, so I feel that Olof, even though he's not really getting much from these pushes into the B-bomb site, he's kind of like, you know, one of the, like, kind of like a football player, just constantly trying to force, you know, not an offside, of course, but kind of trying to constantly play just on the edge of the offside.
Right. Yeah, okay, I see where you're going with this.
And at some point it will work, but this time it's actually JW making it work.
And now the first kill here, KGMB going down, so a 5-4 in favor of Fnatic. It's a great start for the Swedes, who's still not really committed to anything. A minute and 20 to play with as well. Cream's getting a kill on Kerrigan as well. That's going to be 5-3. I feel like now this is going to be their cue of just pushing on a bombsite. That's what they usually do. Is that a lot of patience and Device is going to connect on a shot to Flusha. So it's going back and forth. JW being down low as well. The Device with another kill finally gets destroyed by Olof. So
JW finds the angle through the smoke.
3-1 now.
And JW looking for more. With 11 HP, this guy is not afraid of anything. He kind of... That's actually brilliant play. Krims shoots the wall, baits out Sipnix, and JW has the angle. Beautiful, beautiful stuff.
Yeah, now, what we thought would probably not happen just happened. It's a 3.